श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामिभगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। ॐ यो ब्रह्माणजातिगुरुं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्ना यान्त्रिक संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। एटींथ अधिकरण 31 सूत्र हैज अ वृत्ति विच सेज पूर्वम सगुण निर्गुण विद्यासु मार्गस्य भावाभाव व्यवस्था यथा उक्ता तथा। सो पूर्व अर्लियर व्हाट वाज सीन सगुण निर्गुण विद्यासु मार्गस्य भाव अभाव व्यवस्था वाज सीन भाव एंड अभाव व्यवस्था ऑफ व्हाट मार्ग। सो इन सगुण विद्या as a phala there will be marga, there will be travel involved, whereas in nirguna vidya as a phala there won't be any travel involved, there will be no marga. So abhava yavastha, so bhava yavastha of marga with respect to the saguna vidya, saguna upasana, and nirguna vidya, nirguna brahma jnana will lead to no marga. So margasya abhava yavastha yatha ukta, this was stated in that similar manner, tatha saguna vidyasu api yavasthastu इति दृष्टांत संगत्या इदमाह। पूर्व पक्षी सेज दैट इवन इन सगुण विद्या देर लेट देर बी व्यवस्था, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ व्यवस्था, भाव अभाव व्यवस्था ऑफ मार्ग। सो मार्गस्य भाव अभाव व्यवस्था इन सम सगुण विद्यास एज अ रिजल्ट देर इज मार्ग विच इज अटेन्ड, वेर एज इन सम सगुण विद्या वेर फलरूप मार्ग इज नॉट मेंशन देर लेट देर बी नो मार्ग, देर बी मुक्ति। दिस इज दी अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट वी गेट सेज दी पूर्व पक्षी। टू दैट एज अ रिस्पॉन्स टू दैट भगवान सूत्रकार ब्रिंग्स अप द अधिकरण अनियमाधिकरण मीनिंग देर इज नो नियम मीनिंग सम सगुण विद्या उपासकास विल गेट मार्ग देर ट्रेवल एंड देर बाय दिल अटेन सम लोका एंड सम सगुण विद्या उपासकास विल नॉट अटेन एनी मार्ग they'll get mukti here, that kind of a niyama is not there. Meaning what? It is aniyama. Aniyama meaning there is no rule differentiating marga prapti and marga abhava. Marga bhava and marga abhava, such vyavastha is not there. So aniyama meaning all of the saguna vidya upasakas, saguna brahma upasakas will attain marga, will attain गति, देल ट्रेवल टू सम लोक एंड देर बाय भगवान सूत्रकार सेज अनियम सर्वेशाम अवरोध शब्दानुमानाभ्याम। अनियम सर्वेशाम अवरोध शब्दानुमानाभ्याम अनियम, देर इज नो सच रूल डिफरेंशिएटिंग मार्ग भाव एंड मार्ग अभाव फॉर सगुण विद्या उपासकास अनियम। सर्वेशाम उपासकानां सर्वेषां उपासनानां उपासकानां च अनियमः मार्ग प्राप्तिः मीनिंग देयर विल बी मार्ग प्राप्ति। मार्ग प्राप्ति भाव अभावस्य अनियमः, देयरफॉर मार्ग प्राप्ति भावः, देयर विल बी मार्ग प्राप्ति फॉर ऑल सगुण विद्या उपासकास एंड इन सच उपासनास एज अ फल। एंड शब्दानुमानाभ्याम अवरोधः, शब्दानुमानाभ्याम ड्यू टू शब्द एज प्रमाण एंड अनुमान अवरोधः देयर इज सच अटेनमेंट ऑफ ड्यू टू श्रुति एंड स्मृति। शब्दानुमान मीनिंग ड्यू टू श्रुति एंड स्मृति देयर इज सच अ कंक्लूजन दैट वी रीच, देयर इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन to attainment of mukti here and now. You have to have travel involved and go to a particular loka. Therefore, this niyama is not possible as to some will get mukti whereas some will travel if all of them are saguna vidya upasakas. Atra purvapakshe niyatasya margasya. Atra purvapakshe niyatasya margasya anupasamhara. Siddhante tu niyatasya margasya upasamhara iti phalaveda. Purvapakshi says that this niyata marga, the marga which is discussed as per the shruti, where marga is discussed, there marga should be involved. Where marga is not discussed, in such upasanas, upasamhara of this marga should not be done. So anupasamhara of the marga, where it is not heard. Siddhante tu, in siddhanta however, niyatasya upasamhara, this marga is nitya to saguna brahma upasakas. Saguna vidya will lead to a marga. Reaching that saguna brahma, in a particular form you see brahma, it will lead to particular result. Therefore upasamvara of the marga, even where marga is not heard, it should be brought in from swashakha or shakantara, another shakha iti phala bheda. This is the difference between the purvapaksha and the siddhanta. Saguna upasaneshu kvachit panchagni upasanadishu marga shruyate, kvachit tu vaishvanaradishu na shruyate. In panchagni vidya upasana, panchagni upasana, which is saguna upasana, there in some places such as those, marga is heard, such kind of a archiradi marga travel is involved. Kvachit tu, whereas in some upasana, saguna upasanas like Vaishvanara, Vaishvanara is a saguna upasana, so Vaishvanaradishu na shruyate, marga is not heard, archiradi marga is not heard. Tatra kim yeshu marga shruta teshameva tasya niyamaha kim va sarvesham aniyamaha iti sandehe. When there is a doubt as to wherever the marga is heard, such as in panchagni vidya, there alone marga is there. They alone, meaning those who do panchagni upasana, they will get the travel with a particular archiradi marga. And others where Vaishvanara upasana are done, and those who do such upasanas, they'll not attain the marga, archiradi marga. Is that the case? Kimva sarvesham, or all of them will, all the saguna vidya upasakas, whether they do panchagni, whether they follow panchagni upasana or Vaishvanara upasana, whether all of them will get, or all of the upasanas have this marga as a phala, iti sandeha. When such doubt comes up, vidya vishesha prakaranat niyamaha iti purvapaksha. Because vidya vishesha prakarana, prakarana is of a particular vidya, whether it is panchagni vidya or vaishvanara vidya. So prakarana is limited to that particular vidya, therefore phala mentioned there should also be limited only to that particular vidya upasana. It should not be carried and mixed with the other prakarana gata upasana, such as panchagni vidya has a result mentioned as a particular marga prapti, and in Vaishvanaradi upasana it is not heard. Prakarana is being different, you should not carry the phala across to Vaishvanare Naradi upasana from panchagni upasana, says the Purvapakshi. Idi Purvapakshaha Siddhantastu, whereas Siddhanta is what? Sarvesham Saguna Upasana Nam Margasya Aniyamaha. There is no particularization of this rule, there is no limitation of this rule of Marga Prapti, which is mentioned in one Saguna Upasana. Therefore, all Saguna Upasanas will have such Marga Prapti, that is the Aniyamaha. There is no such specific rule, it is general. Marga is general to all Saguna Upasakas and Upasanas. Upasanas have the phala in the form of marga, means upasakas will travel by such marga. Nanu anima abhyupagame prakarana virodha, says the Purvapakshi. He says that if you do not accept the niyama, meaning you accept anima, if you say that there is no such particularization rule, then this prakarana virodha will take place. You will have crossed over prakarana where prakarana limitation is not followed. You will have broken the prakarana rules, prakarana contradiction will take place. Siddhanti answers, naishvasti virodha, such virodha is not there. So there is no such virodha, avirodha. I may have mistakenly read as avarodha, avirodha. There is no such contradiction at all. Why? In the sutra, I may have read as avarodha, which is going to come up in another sutra. This is avirodha. There is no such contradiction. Kutaha, why? Shabdanumanabhyam. Shruti smriti is the meaning of shabda and anumana respectively. So, shruti smriti bhyam. Due to shruti and smriti being pramana there, which show that there is no prakrana virodha. Why? Because Shruti and Smriti have Vakyas which show that Prakarana Virodha cannot take place. What appears as Prakarana Virodha, that is not stronger to Shruti, Smriti, Vakyas. So, Vakya is a stronger Pramana compared to Prakarana to interpret the meaning for Mimamsa. Thereby, Shruti and Smritis are quoted by the Siddhanti. तद्य इत्थं विदुः ये चेमे अरण्ये श्रद्धा तपेत्युपासते ते अर्चिषम् अभिसंभवन्ति इत्याद्या श्रुतिः शुक्लकृष्णे गतिह्येते जगतः शाश्वते मते एकया यात्यम् अनावृत्तिम् अन्ययावर्तते पुनः. सो श्रुति एंड स्मृति आर कोटेड. श्रुति सेज तद्य यः इत्थं विदुः, वन हु नोज इन दिस मैनर. And what is that? Does upasana in this manner. Knows and does the upasana. Ye cha ime aranye shraddha tapa iti upasate. These who are aranya, in the aranya meaning sannyasis or the third and the fourth ashrama follows basically. So, brahmacharya, Grahastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyasa. So, Vanaprastha and Sannyasis also can be accounted for there, who do upasanas, who have left the Griha, those are in Aranya. So, Aranya meaning Vanaprasthas and Sannyasis, Shraddha Tapaiti Upasate. They do upasana in this manner, Shraddha and Tapa in that manner. Te Archisham Abhisambhavanti. They attain Archiradi Marga, that has been mentioned, Ityadhyaya Shruti, such Shrutis are there, which is a generic Aniyamaha. There is a, those who do such upasanas, they attain Archiradi Marga is given. Ityadhyaya Shruti hi, and Shukla Krishna Gati hiyate Jagata Shashwate Mate. It is a Shashwata Gati. Both Gati, Shukla and Krishna Gati, are Shashwata, meaning even if it is not mentioned in the Shruti, it will be attained. In a particular Shruti, it is not mentioned. From another Shruti, it is established that this Shukla or the Krishna Gati will be attained. Based on what? Based on Upasana or Pitraloka attainment, Krishna Gati or Shukla Gati also, where Devaloka, Brahmaloka Gati. This is Shashwata. All Upasakas will attain Shukla Gati or Archiradi Marga. And Pitraloka Prapti Krishna Gati is there for those who do karma. So karmana Pitralokaha, upasana will lead to Devaloka, Brahmaloka ityadi is well known. Therefore Shashwata, it is Shashwata. These gatis are Shashwata, considered so. Mate ekaya yati anavrittim anyaya avartate punaha. With one marga, one doesn't come back. Meaning, till the Kalpanta one does not come back. Till Kalpanta, it is longer. The stay is longer. In this Kalpa one does not return. Whereas, Anyaya Avartate Puna, whereas with another Marga, Krishna Marga, one takes birth after the Swarga Prapti Ityadi, as we see in the Panchagni Vidya. Avartate Puna, Janma is attained sooner before the end of the Kalpa, whenever the Punya is exhausted in Pitraloka, Swargaloka, Ityad. Ityadya Smritihi, such Smritis are also there, Tabhyam Ityatha, these are the Hetus. Now what about the Prakarana Virodha then? To that answer is given, Evancha Panchagni Vidam Iva Vidyantara Shilinam Api Avisheshena Archaradi Marga Pratipadaka Vakyena Prakaranam Badhyam Iti Bodhyam. Prakarana is a weaker pramana compared to the vakyas, and vakyas are mentioned archiradi marga pratipadaka vakyas, those which reveal that there is attainment of Archiradi Marga, for whom, for Panchagni with as per the Shruti, and where Panchagni with will attain, that is clear. But then Vidyantara Shilinam Api Avisheshena. Whereas those who are following Vaishvanara Vidya Ityadi, which is different from Panchagni Vidya, so Vidyantara Shilinapi, those who follow that kind of an upasana, they also avisheshana, they also will attain avisheshana archiradi marga, because such vakya is there, shruti and smriti vakyas are there. So vakyena prakranam badhyam, prakrana is badhita by vakya pramana iti bodhyam, because we have seen shruti linga vakya prakrana sthana samakhyanam samavaye paradorbalyam artha viprakarshat. There is gradation of pramanyam, superiority in pramana. Shruti is the strongest and samakhya is the weakest. In that shruti linga vakya is there, third and fourth is prakrana. So third pramana vakya is stronger than fourth prakrana, fifth being sthana and sixth last one being samakhya. So vakya is a stronger pramana which will counter and do badha of prakrana. Thereby it is established that every saguna upasaka or every saguna upasana will give phala in the form of, to the upasaka in the form of marga prakti. Purvam mukti phalatvat nirguna vidyayam margaha nirarthakaha brahmaloka prapti phalatvat saguna vidyayam marga sarvatra arthavan iti vyavastha kruta. The earlier adhikarana is over. The next adhikarana, yavad adhikara adhikaranam, there the introduction brings up a purvapaksha, where Purvapakshi is saying Purvam Mukti Phalatvat Nirguna Vidyayam Margaha Nirarthakaha. So Nirguna Vidya, Nirguna Brahma Vidya, Brahma Jnana gives Mukti as a Phala. So Mukti Phalatvat, Nirguna Brahma Vidya has Mukti as the Phala. It is not an Upasana, it is Brahma Jnana. So Nirguna Brahma Jnana Tattvamasi Mahavakya, Aham Brahmasmi Vakya Ityadi Jnana leads to what? Nirguna Brahma being oneself as one Swarupa being known. Therefore, it leads in Mukti as a Phala, Mukti Phalatvat. Therefore, Marga, travel by any Marga is meaningless, Nirarthaka, because there is Ekameva Advitiya Brahma, there is no Marga, there is no Loka, there is no Sharira itself, let alone Sukshma Sharira and something else being there which is attained with the association tadatmya sambandha of this sukshma sharira. That itself is not possible, because aikya siddhi ekameva advitiya brahma siddhi has taken place. This advaita siddhi will not let anything else be there. In understanding, there is no marga, there is no loka, there is no sharira, there is no other Brahma or Abrahma, therefore there is no prapti at all, there is no marga, there is no real attainment or travel at all. However, Brahmaloka prapti phalatva saguna vidyayam, whereas in saguna vidya has the phala as what? Brahmaloka. Brahmaloka, attainment of the Brahmaloka is the ultimate result of saguna vidya, upasana. Therefore, marga sarvatra arthavan, wherever the marga is not mentioned, if saguna vidya is being talked about, then the phala will be marga. Whether it leads to brahmaloka, devaloka, ityadi, various lokas are there attained with the same marga, shukla marga, archiradi marga. Finally, the goal is to reach brahmaloka of all upasanas. Therefore, even if some upasanas which are saguna upasanas, they do not mention brahmaloka as the phala, some archiradi marga as the phala, travel, even then the travel has to be brought from the other shakha or other upasana, other prakarana in the swashakha also, where phala is mentioned to a particular saguna vidya, saguna upasana, and thereby arthavan, this marga is meaningful in all saguna vidyas, saguna upasanas. Vyavasthakruta, iti vyavasthakruta, this is the arrangement that was discussed and established by the Siddhanti in the earlier adhikarana. Sana yukta, that vyavastha is not appropriate it is not proper, says the Purvapakshi. Why so? Because nirgunavidamapi itihasadu punarjanma darshanena nirgunavidyayaha muktisadhanatva asambhavat iti akshepa sangatya idamaha. There is an akshepa sangati. He is objecting to such vyavastha being made by Siddhanti as to nirguna brahma with nirguna vidya phala to the nirguna brahma with is mukti, which means there is no travel involved. If there is no travel involved, then there is no return also possible. But punarjanma is heard, punarjanma darshana, itihasadu in itihasa etc. Historically we see that nirguna brahma with nirguna with nirguna vidya, nirguna jnana, those who had such nirguna jnana, they also had punarjanma. Chiranjeevis are well known. So chiranjeevis such as what? Ashwatthama, Balirvyaso, Hanumanscha, Vibhishanah, Krupah, Parashuramascha, Saptaite, Chiranjeevinah. So seven chiranjeevis are well known: Ashwatthama, Bali, Vyasa, Hanuman, Vibhishana, Krupacharya, Parashurama. So all these seven are what? Chiranjeevi. In Shastra it is heard in Itihasa Ityadi Purana. So they were Nirguna Brahmavit. If not those, then others are mentioned in the Vritti, we'll see in the next sutra, in the current sutra, that is going to come up. So punarjanma darshana nirguna vidyayaha mukti sadhanatva asambhava. Therefore nirguna vidya leading to mukti, meaning being a sadhana to mukti, that itself is not established, because those who had nirguna vidya, they had punarjanma. Then how can there be mukti as a phala? If mukti were the phala, mukti was the phala of this nirguna vidya, then they wouldn't have been born again. But we see that they were born in itihasa. Therefore mukti sadhanatva is not there for nirguna vidya. It is impossible, asambhavad ityakshepa sangatya. This is the objection by the Purvapakshi. Therefore you cannot say, make such vyavastha as to nirguna vidya followers, nirguna brahma jnanis do not have marga, they do not travel, whereas saguna vidya upasakas travel. Thereby yavad adhikara adhikaranam comes up. The sutra there is yavad adhikaram avasthitir adhikarikanam, yavad adhikaram avasthitir adhikarikanam. So Bhagavan sutrakara says yavat adhikaram, yavad adhikaram, as long as there is adhikara, adhikara in janma, that adhikara in janma is due to prarabdha. As long as prarabdha is there, prarabdha, usually what we know is only, it is like a short arrow, all right, but it is only limited to single janma. But there is no such niyama really. There are rare cases of these avatara purushas that we understand in itihasa, where there is multiple janma prarabdha. So yavad adhikaram, as long as prarabdha karma is there, yavad adhikaram avasthitihi adhikarikanam, that is a padachheda. So yavad adhikaram, as long as there is adhikara prarabdha karma pending, yavad adhikaram yavad prarabdha karma, tavat, tavat can be added, yavat is there, so long, tavat what? Adhikarikanam avasthitihi. Adhikarikanam avasthiti means those who have prarabdha karma pending, those who have such prarabdha across multiple janmas, avasthitihi, punarjanma will take place, they will remain in sharira. Punarjanma or continuous stay. Chiranjeevis taking different shariras is also possible. They appear in different shariras. It is said that wherever Rama Bhajana takes place, Bhagavan Rama Bhajan is going on Bhajana, and there Anjaneya, Bhagavan Anjaneya will take some form and appear there. So he'll rejoice in Rama Bhajana, Rama Smarana, wherever it takes place, Rama Nama, there Hanuman will be available in some form. We may not be able to recognize, but he is present in some form. Therefore, multiple shariras can be taken. But here we'll see specific mentions of Nirguna Brahma with in this Sutra Vritti. Atra Purvapakshe Nirguna Vidyayaha Kaivalya Ahitutvat Marga Upasamhara Siddhante Tasya Tasyaha Tadhetutva Dhravyat Taru Anupasamhara Iti Phalaveda. So the difference between Purvapakshi and Siddhanti, Purvapaksha and Siddhanta is in Purvapaksha Nirguna Vidya does not have Kaivalya Hetutvam. So kaivalya hetutva kaivalya ahetutvat, because nirguna vidya has no hetu, is not a hetu, does not have hetutva, meaning is not a hetu to kaivalya, kaivalya prapti, mukti. Therefore what? Marga upasamhara. Marga has to be clubbed together. Although it is not heard in nirguna vidya prakarana, you have to bring it from saguna vidya prakarana and add it together, club it together. Guna upasamhara should be done, phala upasamhara should be done, marga prapti will be there for nirguna vidya also, nirguna vidya upasakas also and jnanis also. Siddhante, in siddhanta however, tasyaha tadhetutva dravyat, because there is dhruvatva of tadhetutva, tadhetutva for tasya, tasyaha, tasya is nirguna vidya, strilinga. So for stri, nirguna vidya, nirguna jnana has what? Nirguna jnana or nirguna vidya has tadhetutva dhruvyam, dhruvatva of tadhetutva. Tadhetutva is kaivalya hetutva. Kaivalya hetutva is dhruva. It is nitya. It is very much clear across Vedanta. Therefore, anupasamhara. You should not do marga. Tad anupasamhara is marga anupasamhara. Marga should not be brought in at all. Marga is irrelevant. It is meaningless. Anarthaka. Nirarthaka. Iti phala vedaha. This Shruti or Smriti, in because what has been mentioned here, Itihasadu. So Adi Padena, Purana Ityadi also, Smriti Granthas can be brought in. And those are quoted here. Apantartama Nama Kalidvaparayoho Sandhu Vishnu Niyogat Krishna Dvaipayana Sambhabhuva Ityadina Apantartama Vasishtadi Nam Nirguna Brahma Vidam Purarjanma Smaryate. So punarjanma is heard in smritis, such as what? Apantaratama nama. There was this rishi called as Apantaratama. And in the sandhi, sandhau, sandhi of Kali and Dwapara. Kali and Dwapara, in the sandhi, in between Kali and Dwapara yugas, this Apantaratama, Vishnu niyoga, due to niyoga of Vishnu, due to adesha of Vishnu, Bhagavan Vishnu, he was born as what? Krishna Dvaipayanaha Sambhavuva. He was born as Krishna Dvaipayanaha. So this Apantaratama Vasishta, and Vasishta also it is heard, Vasishta Adinam. Vasishtasya Mitra Varunabhyam Janma. Sanat Kumara Adipadana. So Sanat Kumarasya Skanda Janma. Skanda was born as what? Sanat Kumara. Tathaiva Daksha Narada Ityadinam. Daksha Narada Ityadi. They are many Nirguna Brahma Vit who are born. So Nirguna Brahma Vidam Punarjanma Smaryate. They are born. We hear this. Those who had Nirguna Brahma Jnana, even they are born again. So born, being born is possible only if there is Marga involved. Without Marga one cannot be born. Therefore Mukti Hetu is not there in this Nirguna Vidya or Brahma Jnana. And thereby, there can be Janma again and again, there can be travel in Marga, just like as a phala for Saguna Vidya. Tatrakim Vidushah Vartamana Deha Patanantaram Dehantara Prapti Rasti Nava Iti Sandehe Asti Iti Purav Pakshah. So now, after the drop of this body, will they get Brahma with those who have Nirguna Brahma Jnana, Kim Vidusha, Vidusha for Vidwan, which Vidwan? Brahma Vidwan, which Brahma? Nirguna Brahma. So those who have Brahma Jnana, Nirguna Brahma Jnana for them, or Vidusha for a singular it is used here, Vidusha for that Brahma with, Nirguna Brahma with, after the drop of current body, Vartamana Deha Patanantaram, after the current body is being dropped, Dehantara Prapti Rastinava Iti Sandeh. Will there be another body attained? Will he be embodied again or not? Asti iti Purvapaksha. Purvapaksha says that yes, he will be born again. even the Nirguna Brahma Jnani will be born again. Siddhantas too, whereas Siddhanta is what? Apantara Tamah Prabhuti Naam Adhikarikanam Loka Vyavastha Hetushu Adhikareshu Parameshwarena Niyuktanam Samyak Darshanataha Prakshina Karmanam Yavad Adhikaram Avasthitihi Yavad Prarabdha Karma Avasthitihi Tasya Prarabdha Karmanaha Bhoge Nakshaye प्रतिबंधकांतराभावात् अप्रतिबंध साक्षात्कार वर्तमान देह पातानंतरम कैवल्यम संपादयति इति न देहांतर प्राप्तिरिति सिद्धम. अ लॉन्ग सेंटेंस. द बेसिक आइडिया इज न देहांतर प्राप्त देहांतर प्राप्ति ही नास्ति इति सिद्धम. सिद्धांत इज एस्टैब्लिशिंग दैट देयर इज नो दे अनदर बॉडी अटेन्ड बाय दिस ब्रह्मविद. कैवल्यम संपादयति इति हेतु बिकॉज द निर्गुण ब्रह्म ज्ञान मेक्स हिम अटेन कैवल्य. दिस ब्रह्म ज्ञानी अटेन कैवल्य व्हेन वर्तमान देह पातानंतरम आफ्टर द ड्रॉप ऑफ द करंट बॉडी. सो व्हाट हैज बीन सेड इज अपांतर तम प्रवृत्ति नाम दिस अपांतर तम एंड अदर्स विच हैव बीन मेंशनड वशिष्ठ इत्यादि. Those who were Nirguna Brahma Jnanis, but they still attained another Janma. So they had multiple Janma Prarabdha. But after the last Janma, where Prarabdha is over, that time what will happen? They will attain Mukti. Meaning there will be no other Deha attained by them. Similarly, most of these Jivas do not have multiple देह प्रार मल्टीपल जन्म प्रारब्धास. ज्ञानीज मोस्ट ऑफ द ज्ञानीज विल हैव अ सिंगल जन्म प्रारब्ध द करेंट जन्म एंड व्हेन द प्रारब्ध इज ओवर दे अटेन मुक्ति. ओनली दोज हु हैव बीन पर्टिकुलरली ऑर्डेन्ड बाय भगवान विष्णु इत्यादि टू प्ले अ पर्टिकुलर रोल दैट रोल मे गो अक्रॉस मल्टीपल जन्मस. They can be Chiranjeevis in this Kalpa, they can attain multiple Janmas, all that is possible. But these are very rare. Such Jnani, they have Jnana all right, but they have a particular purpose, particular role to play in this samsara. To teach Pravritti Dharma or Nivritti Dharma. So they are playing their role. So that kind of a Jnani will be, may be born again and again in different ways because Prarabdha has been given for multiple janmas to do loka sangraha. So apantarata prabhriti naam, those which have been given an example by this purvapakshi, the purvapakshi as to having brahma jnana but being born again. Adhikarikanam, they are adhikarika, they have loka vyavastha hetushu adhikareshu parameshwarena niyuktanam. Those who have been ordained by parameshwara for a particular hetu, loka vyavastha hetushu adhikarishu. So, some particular instruction is given to them as to what should they be doing in a particular janma, in another janma. Therefore, this loka vyavastha hetushu, this should be a single word here. Loka vyavastha hetushu adhikarishu. So adhikarikana means in loka vyavastha, loka sangraha vyavastha, that kind of vyavastha, some work is pending. So adhikarishu, they have some adhikara in prabhritinam parameshwara niyuktanam. They have been ordained in some particular role which is a hetu in loka vyavastha, in loka sangraha, to attain some result in the loka. So they have been particularly niyukta, they have been given some role to play by Parameshwara, Parameshwarana. Therefore, Samyak Darshanataha Prakshina Karmanam. With the Samyak Darshana of Mahavakya, Samyak Darshana, Atma Darshana, Brahmatma Darshana, due to that they are Prakshina Karma, meaning they have Prakarshena Kshina Karma, Karmani, you can say Prakarshena क्षीण कर्माणि येषाम और क्षीणानि कर्माणि येषाम ते प्रक्षीण कर्माः एंड तेषां प्रक्षीण कर्मणां. दोज हु हैव देर कर्मा विच इज कंप्लीटली क्षीण ड्यू टू सम्यक दर्शन बट वॉट हेज हैपेंड प्रारब्ध इज स्टिल देर संचिता इज क्षीण आगम ही आगम कर्म इज ऑल्सो ओवर आगामी कर्म सो आगामी कर्म एंड संचित कर्म इज ऑलरेडी बर्नड बिकॉज सम्यक दर्शन इज हेतु फॉर दैट सो प्रक्षीण कर्म दे आर प्रक्षीण कर्म हवेवर यावद अधिकारम अवस्थिति ही यावत प्रारब्ध कर्म अवस्थिति एज लॉन्ग एज प्रारब्ध कर्म इज देर तस्य प्रारब्ध कर्मण भोगे न क्षये दैट प्रारब्ध कर्म कैन गो ओनली बाय भोग एंड दैट भोग इज बाय वॉट बाय लोकव्यवस्था हेतु अधिकार इज गिवन बाय परमेश्वर सो एज लॉन्ग एज दिस वर्क इज नॉट ओवर यू कीप ऑन डूइंग दिस सो दैट दैट मच विल बी देर प्रारब्ध देर फोर तस्य प्रारब्ध कर्मण भोगे न क्षये They have to undergo bhoga of such prarabdha karma, act as per Bhagavan's will and get things done for loka vyavastha. Therefore, pratibandhaka antara bhavat, there being no other pratibandhaka. Sanchita is not there, agami is not there, no new karma is being produced because it is all as per the will of Bhagavan, as per the karma of the others. So for loka sangraha, In this body, this jnani will be doing this karma, thereby apratibandha sakshatkara. The sakshatkara is not blocked by anything. They remain in Brahma Bhava and the sharira gets done what has to be done, be it in one janma or multiple janmas. That is based on their own prarabdha, which is based on Bhagavan's will, which is based on the prarabdha of all the ajnanis whom this Jnani in this particular body is serving or is causing benefit. Vartamana deha patanantra. However, when this particular body, ongoing body drops off for that Jnani, then kaivalyam sampadeti. That Jnana itself will bring out kaivalya for this Jnani, Brahma Jnani, Nirguna Brahma Jnani. Whose sharira is continuing across multiple janmas as seen in itihasa purana ityadi iti na iti heto na dehantar praptir iti siddham therefore there is no other janma for such whose prarabdha gets over be it in multiple janmas but they are not bound at all they are free because of samyak jnana being there and sanchita agami being burnt In the very janma, the first janma itself where jnana took place and the rest of the janmas are based on Parameshwara's direction as to multiple janma prarabdha being there. This is very rare and we see certain examples in Shastra. Thereby this yavad adhikara adhikaranam is also over. Puro yatha in the next adhikarana introduction Bhagavan सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र से पूर्व यथा आधिकारिक पुरुषाणाम आरब्ध कर्मवशादेव देहांतरारंभ सिद्धे न संचित कर्मांतरस्य तद्हेतुत्वम् इत्युक्तम् तथा यह अपि सो सम दृष्टांत संगति इज गिवन सिमिलर टू व्हाट यू हैव डन वील टेक अप अनदर सेक्शन फ्रॉम अनदर श्रुति सेज द पूर्व पक्षी सो वॉट हैज बीन डन बाय द सिद्धांती आधिकारिक पुरुषाणम आर्ध कर्मवशादेव देहांतर आरंभ सिद्धे दिस प्रारब्ध कर्म बीइंग लाइक अ शॉर्ट एरो कैनॉट बी टेकन बैक सो इवन फॉर ज्ञानीज इफ देर इज मल्टीपल जन्म प्रारब्ध पेंडिंग देर फॉर वॉट आधिकारिक पुरुषाणम मीनिंग फॉर हूम अधिकार इन More janmas is pending, prarabdha karma is pending. Thereby, arabdha karma vashadeva, arabdha is prarabdha karma. Prarabdha karma vashadeva, under the influence of this prarabdha karma, which is the only karma pending, due to that alone, what dehantara arambha siddhe. There being siddhi of arambha of another deha. Another deha is attained due to such prarabdha. Therefore, what? Na sanchita karmantarasya tadhetuttam ityuktam. Sanchita karma is already burnt in the first janma where the jnana took place. Brahma jnana took place. therefore sanchita karma has vanished and sanchita karma is not the hetu for another prarabdha being carved out to give another janma. Therefore what tatha yapi, similarly therefore what tadhetutvam ityuktam, meaning na tadhetutvam, sanchita karma which is different from this prarabdha karma has already been burned and thereby sanchita karma is not the cause for another janma, but prarabdha karma itself is the cause for another janma. For such specific so called avatar purushas that we consider Bhagavan Vyasa Vasishta ityadi to be tatha yapi, similarly पूर्वपक्षी सेज इहापि हियर तत्तद् वाक्योक्तैः एव निषेधैः उपलक्षणतया सर्वद्वैत निषेध सिद्धेः न शाखांतरीय निषेधानां ब्रह्मधी हेतुत्वम् इति दृष्टांत संगत्या इदमाह. Thereby पूर्वपक्षी ब्रिंग्स इन अनदर सेक्शन, अनदर सिचुएशन वेयर हाउ डज द ब्रह्मधी टेक प्लेस, ब्रह्म बुद्धि. So what is the Brahma Buddhi Hetu? Nisheda Shruti is the Hetu. Neti Neti Prakriya we have seen multiple times with various Shrutis. Now the Puropakshi says that in one section some Nisheda is there in Swashaka. In Swashaka Antargata Upanishad Vedanta Vakyas we see Nisheda of some Gunas is heard. Thereby Brahmadi Brahma Buddhi takes place by Neti Neti Prakriya. And that is an upalakshana for sarva nisheda. So you need not bring in another shakha antargata nisheda vakya here for brahmadi. Brahma buddhi takes place in your swashakha itself with some nisheda, some guna nisheda. You need not bring in, meaning you need not do upasamhara, you need not club together nisheda in other shakhas to get brahma jnana. This is what is claimed by the Purvapakshi. So he says that just like prarabdha karma is hetu and you need not bring sanchita karma there for punarjanma of this brahmajnanis, multiple janma prarabdha karma itself can be read there, understood there. Similarly here where nisheda of some gunas in swashakha itself will can lead to brahmajnana, then why would you need to bring Nisheda Shruti from another Shakha? It is not needed. So the Nisheda Vakyas from other Shakha, other Shakhas are not Brahmadhi Hetu. They are not the cause for understanding Brahma. Swashakha Antargata Nisheda itself is having the Hetu for Brahma Buddhi to take place, Brahma Jnana to take place. And thereby Aksharadhi Adhikaranam comes up. Aksharadhi Adhikaranam. Akshara Buddhi, Akshara is Brahma. Akshara Brahma. So Brahma Buddhi Adhikaranam. Brahmadhi Adhikarana. Aksharadhi Adhikaranam. Bhagavan Sutrakara says Aksharadhyan Tavaroda Samanyatad Bhava Abhyam Aupasadavattaruktam. अक्षरध्यान्तवरोध सामान्यत्तद्भावाभ्याम् औपसदवत्तरुक्तम्. सो अक्षरध्याम् तु अवरोधः सामान्यतद्भावाभ्याम् औपसदवत् तदुक्तम् तद् उक्तम्. तद् एंड उक्तम् आर सेपरेट पदास्. तद् उक्तम् लाइक अर्लियर वी हैव सीन तद् उक्तम् पूर्व मीमांसा शास्त्रे तद् उक्तम्. इन मीमांसा शास्त्र जैमिनी सूत्र इट हैज बीन सेड लाइक औपसद Aupasadavat, Aupasada Homavat. Like Aupasada Homa, it has been mentioned in Purva Mimamsa, that can be applied here. What is the meaning of the rest of the sutra? Aksharadhyam, Brahmadhyam, towards Brahmadhi, Brahma Buddhi, Aksharadhyam, Brahmadhyam tu. However, in the case of Brahma Buddhi, Akshara Buddhi, not na, Avarodha. Avarodha is Nisheda Upasamhara, Avarodha. Nisheda Upasamhara, Nisheda meaning there is no difficulty or obstruction in bringing the other Shruti Antargata, you should bring the other Nisheda Vakyas from other Shrutis. Avarodha. निषेध उपसंहार दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अवर वाज निषेध उपसंहार लाइक दी व्हाट इज हेतु देर सामान्य तद्भावाभ्याम सामान्य एंड तद्भाव तद्भाव तद इज ब्रह्म सो सामान्य सामान्य व्हाट इज सामान्य ब्रह्म ज्ञान सामान्य इज देर सर्वश्रुतिषु ब्रह्म प्रतिपादन सामान्यम समानत्वम इन एवरी श्रुति एवरी शाखा उपनिषद इज रिवीलिंग ब्रह्म सो सामान्य इज देर एंड तद्भाव ब्रह्म भाव एकत्व विच इज एकत्व दैट इज बीइंग टॉट सो ब्रह्म सामान्येन ब्रह्म प्रतिपाद्यते कुत्र सर्वश्रुतिषु सर्वशाखासु सर्वशाखांतर्गत उपनिषत्सु एंड तद्भावाभ्याम ऑल्सो तद्भाव 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 ब्रह्म भाव इज टॉट एक भाव एकत्व रूप ब्रह्म भाव इज टॉट सो ब्रह्म सामान्येन ब्रह्म इज टॉट एंड ब्रह्म इज टॉट एज वन एकमेव अद्वितीय ब्रह्म दैट एकता इज टॉट ब्रह्मत्व इज टॉट वंस जीवत्व इज नॉट देर जीवत्व इज नथिंग बट ब्रह्मत्व जीवा इज नन अदर देन ब्रह्म दैट इज टॉट इन ऑल शाखास देयरफॉर द निषेध विच लैंड्स ऑन दैट काइंड ऑफ अ ब्रह्म अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट निषेध उपसंहार हैज टू बी डन अवरोध इट हैज टू बी ब्रॉट टू स्वशाखा ऑल्सो हाउ सो औपसद वत लाइक औपसद होम इन औपसद होम आई जस्ट मेन्शन दिस हियर एंड विल स्टॉप हियर विल लुक एट द वृत्ति इन द नेक्स्ट पाठ सी औपसद होम देर इज अ पर्टिक्युलर औपसद होम देर सो दुग्ध दधि घृतकृत इष्टियाग सोमयाग पशुयाग देर आर दिस सच थ्री यागास इति त्रिषु उपसद इष्टि उपसद इज अ इष्टि देर एंड उपसदे भव मंत्र औपसद औपसद इज अ मंत्र विच इज इन उपसद यूज इन उपसद देर दिस इज जन इन फोर रात्रि चतुसृषु रात्रिषु कृत याग अहीन अहीन विल बी दिस जामदग्नि अहीन याग विल बी डिस्कस इन दि वृत्ति देर ऑल दैट विल सी लेटर बट देर दि इवन इन दि सामवेद मंत्रास विच आर मेन्शन देर दे शुड बी चैंटेड बाय दि यजुर्वेद यजुर्वेदी अध्वर्यु बिकॉज इट इज मेन्शन सो सो दि मंत्र विच इज इन सामवेद ऑल्दो इट इज इन सामवेद दिस उद्गात्रु ऑफ दि सामवेद शुड नॉट बी चैंटिंग इट दैट हैज अ कनेक्शन संबंध विद दि अध्वर्यु ऑफ दि यजुर्वेदी ऑल्दो दि शाखा इज नॉट यजुर्वेद शाखा इट इज अ सामवेद शाखा बट सामवेद अंतर्गत मंत्र ऑल्सो विल कनेक्ट टू दि सिंस इट इज कनेक्टेड टू दि अध्वर्यु इवन इफ इट इज इन सामवेद इट शुड बी चैंटेड बाय दि अध्वर्यु सो उद्गात्र शुड नॉट बी चैंटिंग इट सामवेद फॉलोअर इज अ उद्गात्र दैट उद्गात्र शुड नॉट बी चैंटिंग दि साम मंत्र दैट साम मंत्र शुड बी चैंटेड बाय दि दिस औपसद औपसद मंत्र शुड बी चैंटेड बाय दि अध्वर्यु ऑफ दि यजुर्वेद यजुर्वेद फॉलोअर शुड बी चैंटिंग दैट मंत्र सो दिस इज वॉट दि तदुक्तम मीन्स दैट हैज बीन एनालाइज इन पूर्वमीमांसा सच कनेक्शन एग्जिस्ट देर फोर यू शुड ब्रिंग वेर एवर सच चैंटिंग इज देर दैट शुड बी ब्रॉट इन एंड इट शुड बी चैंटेड बाय दि अध्वर्यु सिमिलरली हियर वेर एवर निषेध इज डन दैट शुड बी ब्रॉट इन टू स्वशाख ऑल्सो वेर एवर निषेध इज देर ऑल निषेध वाक्य शुड बी ब्रॉट इन बाय दिस ब्रह्म ज्ञान इच्छु वन हू इज दिस निषेध श्रुति एवरीवेर इन ऑल शाखास इज मेंट फॉर दि ब्रह्म ज्ञान जिज्ञासु ब्रह्म जिज्ञासु सो दिस ब्रह्म जिज्ञासु इवन इफ ही इज इन स्वशाखा ही शुड बी चैंटिंग एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑल दिस निषेध वाक्यास फ्रॉम ऑल शाखास वाई बिकॉज देर इज अ संबंध विद दिस ब्रह्म जिज्ञासु जस्ट लाइक इन दि औपसद मंत्र The Upasada mantras have connection with the Adhvaryu, therefore wherever they are chanted, they should be brought in wherever they are mentioned in whichever shaka. They should be chanted, brought in, and having sambandha with advaryu, they should be chanted by advaryu. Similarly, all the nisheda vakya should be understood across shakas by this brahma jijnyasu in whichever shaka following he presents himself. This is the sutrartha. We'll see the vritti in the next partha. आमनायांतिक संसिद्धम आदिमध्यांत वर्जितम आनंदघनम पूर्णम आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। नमस्ते, धन्यवाद।